So I woke up this morning, I was taking a look on CNN, and I found out that it looks like we're going to be flying two humanitarian aid workers, one physician and one aid worker from West Africa to Emory in Atlanta to be treated for active Ebola virus. I disagree with this decision. I'm not saying it's wrong. I just disagree with it. I think it's an unnecessary risk to the public. And I would disagree with it if they were flying the patients to China to be treated, or if they were flying the patients to the Philippines to be treated. Because we need, I feel like if you have a quarantine, you should quarantine it. Now, there's questions of what kind of care the patients will get in the United States versus Africa. If you want me to answer that question, why don't we just fly the ICU to them? Let's give them the ventilators. Let's give them the dialysis machines. Let's give them the drugs. Let's put the lab over there. Let's send all that equipment. Let's send them the surgical suite if they need that. Yeah, for some reason, And you say, well, what about special tests? Well, let's put it on a jet and let's overnight it to Mayo. And then we'll get our answers. That's what happens in, society here. We overnight our. If you got a problem, it takes more than overnight. Sometimes you just send your specimen out to Mayo. They check it out for you. At least that's what happened with my lipid samples. They went to Mayo. They checked it out for me. And then they sent it back. Well, that took 2 weeks. If they made it priority one, which they would for Ebola patients, because that's, life or death, you get it back a lot sooner. A real unnecessary risk, in my opinion. How can we be sure that anybody working with these folks, unless they're kept in quarantine, which they might be, because obviously I don't work in this kind of infectious disease, so there may be protocols in place. But if you're allowing the workers that are working on these folks in the United States to go home, how do we know for sure? How does the person even know for sure that there was no exposure? I mean, people turn up with incidental infections all the time. I mean, there's a reason why there's hospital acquired, why the medical textbooks have hospital acquired infections on their pages now. Healthcare associated pneumonia. It's no longer called hospital acquired pneumonia, but healthcare associated pneumonia. Meaning that if they weren't around healthcare so much, they may have not gotten pneumonia. So, I mean, I understand that the Americans, you want to bring the Americans home, take care of them. But I mean, this is a world problem. This is not just a West Africa problem. And I've been talking to people about this. People need to pay more attention to what's going on outside the United States. And we need to care about what's going on outside the United States, because this is not, we're not, we don't live in an isolated state. We live in a global economy, we live in a global world. We need to take care of each other. So my heart goes out to everybody working in West Africa. You guys are doing a great job. You guys are soldiers of humanity. You're putting your own, own lives at risk to be able to help these other people. And that's, I mean, can't speak highly enough of somebody like that. But I mean, in terms of bringing these folks back, it's you got to make a utility decision. This is utilitarianism right here. I mean, what makes those two people more special than the other folks that are dying, in Africa? Nothing really, because humanity is humanity. A human is a human is a human. Mutual respect for all. Equality for all. So we're not bringing those folks back to be treated at Emory. I understand they are citizens, and so bringing them home to take care of our citizens, I do understand that. Not saying it's the wrong decision, just saying that I disagree with it. I think it's high risk.